Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1577 of our daily Naseehah and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we focus on the 12th of Sha'ban. On the 12th of Sha'ban, 1197 after Hijrah, corresponding to the 13th of July, 1783, the Ottoman Empire's navy destroyed 75 Spanish naval vessels that were attempting to position their soldiers in the harbors of Algeria in an attempt to occupy Algeria. This is always the Western countries' motives, that they want to occupy the Muslim countries, the Arab countries, and they want to steal their resources. We can see today Palestine under occupation. We can see Kashmir in India under occupation. We can see that Afghanistan, the Americans, and before them the Russians, and before them the British. So these are the kuffar mentality, that they always want to occupy Muslim Arab countries. May Almighty Allah decimate and destroy the enemies of Islam and Muslims, whoever they are, wherever they are. Regarding the sunnah of today, it is very sad that we see Muslims in various parts of the world that they eat with the left hand, they drink water with the left hand or juice. Remember Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "The shaitan ya'kulu wa yashrabu bi shimalihi." The shaitan eats with his left and drinks with his left. So we are Muslims. We must ensure we eat with our right hand. In fact, even the method is shown to us, open Shamail Tirmidhi, and it is the index finger, the middle finger, and thereafter the thumb, and that we should use when we are eating. And if we use one to other fingers, so it will be permissible, but sunnah are index, middle finger, and the thumb. And thereafter, remember, when we drink water, juice, or whatever that is permissible in halal, then also use the right hand. And we should always try and practice on every sunnah of Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then we become yuhbibkumullah, the beloved of Almighty Allah, wa yaghfir lakum, and Almighty Allah will forgive you your sins. Surah 3, verse 31. Likewise, that when we are eating fruit, when we are eating sweets, whatever, although some ulama said it's permissible, but best is to sit and eat that as well. Next one, regarding drinking, remember that nowadays it has become fashionable for people to walk, and while they're walking, they're eating, drinking, all these type of things. These type of actions do not befit a true Muslim. Remember that with his food, drink, all that are a ni'mat, bounty of Allah, they'd rather sit, and that will be the best thing to do. Although some ulama, they gave jawaz and they said it's permissible for fruits and so forth. Then remember that the dua for today, so many people are contacting us and saying they're feeling ill, they're feeling sick. Allah alone knows, is it due to the lockdown or because anxiety, worry? These are the duas we should read when we are feeling ill and sick. Number one, the dua of Nabi Ayyub alayhi salatu salam, Surah 21, verse 83, in the 17th juz, 17th part of the Noble Quran. Anni masani yadurru wa anta rahmur rahimin. O Allah, calamity, sickness, distress has afflicted me, whilst you, Allah, you are the most merciful one to show mercy. Many a time when people are worried, tension and so forth, then stress, anxiety overtakes them. So read Surah 21, verse 87. La ilaha illa anta subhanak inni kuntu min al-zalimin. The dua of Nabi Yunus alayhi salatu salam. Surah 21, verse 87, in the 21st juz, 21st supara. Likewise, in Bukhari Sharif mentioned, read Surah Fatiha 7 times and blow on yourself, and then inshallah, Allah Jalla Wala will give us cure. As'alullah al-azim, Rabb al-arsh al-azim, an tashfiyani. As'alullah al-azim, O Allah, I ask you, you are the magnificent one, Ya Allah, Rabb al-arsh al-azim, and Ya Allah, that your throne also is magnificent and you are the sole possessor of it. You grant me shifa, open Mishkat Sharif, Musnad Ahmad. So read this dua several times as well. Dawu maradakum bi sadaqa, mentioned there in Abu Dawood. So remember marasil of Imam Abu Dawood. Give charity for the people who are sick. We can give ourselves, other people give. So may Almighty Allah grant us cure internally and externally. Allahumma anta shafi, la shifa illa shifa'uk, shifa an la yughadiru saqama. Ya Allah, only you give shifa. Ya Allah, give shifa to all those who are ill. May Almighty Allah envelope us in His mercy. Ameen. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Salaamu Alaikum.